A long time ago, in a galaxy far, far away, someone boldly went somewhere, something, blah, blah, blah. But the coolest part was this moon thing that made all these lasers that came together to make a super laser. Do you remember that? It turns out, real life scientists have come up with a way to join smaller laser beams into a super powerful laser thanks to the light bending abilities of diamonds. But before we get into that, let's start with the basics of lasers real quick. Lasers are simply coordinated waves of light. If you could see the waves, they'd all be aligned, going the same direction. The technology was developed in the 1950s, with no real practical use at the time. Today, science uses lasers to precisely measure distances, communicate, etch and cut, cool gases to near absolute zero, image tiny things like bacteria, and hundreds of other world-changing applications. And the more powerful they get, the more possibilities open up. So it behooves scientists to keep upping the power. Essentially, to create a laser, power is added into substances until they lase, or emit aligned laser light, either in a continuous beam or as pulses. The average laser pointer that my cat chases needs a few milliwatts of power to do this. But the US military is testing lasers as powerful as 60 kilowatts. The idea is to take out incoming rockets or mortars or swarms of drones. They're not quite at Alderaan destroying levels yet. But powerful lasers can be more than just death beams. They can be used to image things as small as viruses and bits of DNA. And lasers with even more power could help us ignite fusion. The problem is, you can't just build a single powerful laser willy-nilly. As lasers get more powerful, the heat of the laser mechanism can affect the creation and focus of the beam. So instead, it might be simpler to just take a bunch of smaller beams and point them at the same spot. Scientists have been using that approach for years. Mostly they use mirrors or lenses to focus lots of lasers at a single point. But getting several powerful lasers to focus at the exact place on top of, say, a virus waiting for a selfie is not easy. So it would be better if we could create something sort of like a trademarked star of death. You know what I mean, right? All these lasers combining into one beam, aiming one beam, that's way easier. And now, humanity's Galen Erso has appeared in the form of researchers at Macquarie University. In March 2017, rather than using lenses and mirrors, they grabbed a bit of ultra-pure diamond and let the crystalline structure of the atoms do the rest. They lined up four lasers, one that would shoot straight through the crystal and out the other side, that they called the seed beam, and three that would enter the crystal at an angle, called pump beams. When they were all fired at once, the crystal transferred most of the power of the pump beams to the seed beam, upping its power by almost 4.6 kilowatts. And yeah, that's a lot less powerful than that 60 kilowatt rocket stopper from earlier, but this was just a proof of concept. The researchers are optimistic that using diamonds to combine lasers can raise the power barrier because the ultra-pure diamond doesn't heat up the way traditional technology does. According to the researchers, this technology could be used to make lasers that could propel spacecraft, clean up space junk, or shoot down missiles and drones. It's so simple, it's actually kind of mind-boggling we didn't figure it out sooner. Just, you know, don't ask the scientist to go into a secret installation and build a planet-sized one. It never ends well, okay? So combining a bunch of lasers through a diamond sounds pretty cool, but so does making lasers from jellyfish. I'm not crazy. Trace talks all about that right here. All right, guys, do you think this is the best way to get super powerful lasers, or is there another thing we haven't talked about you think is just awesome? Let us know in the comments, subscribe for more, and I'll see you next time on Seeker.